Welcome to our next Wandering Walks of Wonder adventure. Today we're headed to Warroad, Minnesota. The history of Warroad is a long and rich one, and it begins here in front of this old depot. It was constructed in 1914 according to designs of Canadian architect J. Schofield. The Canadian National Railroad Depot is significant because it helped bring numerous immigrants from the United States that passed on their way to Canada. This particular depot is located on the only section of the Canadian Transcontinental Railroad system which passes through the United States. The station was whose construction was made possible by a treaty between the two countries is believed to be the first depot in the United States constructed by a foreign corporation. This area of Minnesota was first inhabited by the Ojibwe people, who called it kah-bay-kay-nong, which means place of the narrows. The Ojibwe fought a long and fierce war against the Sioux for control of the area, and the name Warroad here in Warroad, Minnesota is derived from what was called the Warroad, two words, that the Sioux used to travel in the area. The first permanent white settlers arrived in Warroad in the late 19th century, and the village was incorporated in 1901. Warroad quickly became a major commercial center thanks to its location on the Lake of the Woods and its access to the Canadian National Railway. The town was also a major center for the fur trade, and the Warroad Fur Company was one of the largest fur trading companies in the region. In the early 20th century, Warroad became a popular destination for tourists who were drawn to the town's beauty and its opportunities for fishing, hunting, and boating. Warroad has also become a major center for hockey, and the Warroad Lakers are one of the most successful high school hockey teams in the state of Minnesota. Today, Warroad is a thriving community with a population of about 2,000 people. It's still a major center for commercial fishing and tourism, and it's also home to a number of manufacturing companies.